Good morning. Welcome to the Deliverance Time broadcast. This ministry comes to you each week with the compliments of the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. You'll find us at lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, on the east bank of the Marara. We know the music which we have selected today will inspire you, and you will be challenged by the message. Stay tuned.
Holy, 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 see what you truly are. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place.
Father, we thank you for this day, the beginning of yet another week. We acknowledge your mercies and praise you for all your blessings. We ask you to use this broadcast to accomplish your purpose. Minister to each of us as we wait in your presence. Help us to submit ourselves to you, that your peace can fill our hearts, our homes, our towns and villages, and the nation as a whole. We give you praise for all that will be accomplished for your glory in these moments. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
To bring something that's a word that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the It's all about you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, every single breath, I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, 'cause it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made. And it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus.
My
my joy to welcome you once more to this week's edition of the Deliverance Time broadcast, sponsored by the members and friends of Eccles Assembly of God. Eccles Assembly is located at Lots 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, right here on the east bank of Demerara. We'll meet at 8:15 this morning for Sunday school. And again, please be reminded that Sunday school is not just for children. We have a class for all ages. Our fellowship service begins at 9:30 this morning, and this is a hybrid event, in-house and online. So just in case you are unable to join us physically, you can connect with us on our Facebook page. That's the Eccles Assembly of God Facebook page for our fellowship service this morning, beginning at 9:30. Tuesday, Lord willing, at 10 in the morning, we'll have our Deliverance Miracle Service. Then on Wednesday at 6:30 in the evening, we have our Bible study. Again, this will be a hybrid event, in-house and online. Remember to write and share with us the specific blessings you have been receiving through this broadcast and our online ministry. You may write to Deliverance Time, Cave of Eccles Assembly, 57 to 59 Public Road, Eccles, East Bank, Demerara. Or you may email us at EcclesAG, all one word, all lowercase, EcclesAG@gmail.com. Also, we have WhatsApp numbers on which you can contact us. And those numbers are 613-2024, 613-2024, and 624-8858, 624-8858. Call us as well on numbers 233-2124 and 233-2982, should you need any further spiritual help. Those numbers again are 233-2124 and 233-2982. Stay tuned and be blessed. I'm reading this morning from the book of Job, chapter 1, starting with verse number 20. It reads, "Then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground and worshipped and said, Naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all this, Job sinned not, nor charged God foolishly." The book of Job deals not only with the problem of suffering, but also with the question of genuine devotion to God. The story is about a man by the name of Job who lived in the land of Uz in the Middle East. The author of the book of Job tells us that Job was blameless and upright, one who feared God and turned away from evil. He had 7 sons and 3 daughters. The Bible says he also had sheep, camels, oxen, asses, and servants. Verse 3 of chapter 1 states that Job was the greatest of all the men of the East. Job was also a devoted father. He was meticulous in his concern for the spiritual welfare of his children. Job's sons often included their sisters in their times of fellowship and feasting with friends. And just to be sure that their sins were all taken care of, Job offered sacrifices for his children after each feast. The offering of sacrifices in those days was quite permissible. So Job was rich, he was respected, he was righteous, but there is something else about Job which we want to consider on the broadcast today, and that is the well-known fact that Job was tested. Yes, severely tested. Now, the problem of the suffering of the righteous has baffled many down through the centuries. People have always asked, why does God permit good people to suffer? Maybe you wondered yourself why some good person whom you were quite familiar with had to die of an awful disease, or perhaps had to be confined to a bed of pain, or even brutally killed. The story of Job offers a solution to these problems. I believe it gives God's answers. Let us take a moment to examine the extent of Job's trials and his response to suffering. The writer of this book gives us a glimpse of the heavenly setting of this ancient story. On a particular day, all of the heavenly court came before God. The word of God says that Satan also came among them. Now, Satan's presence among this heavenly gathering might seem strange. However, the point is not that Satan has the privilege of access, but that he is subject to divine authority and must report to Almighty God concerning his activities on the earth. In the opening of the book of Job, God asks the question. The question was directed to Satan. "Whence comest thou?" Satan answered and said, "From going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it." Now make no mistake about it, my friend. Satan is very active on this planet. He is behind the evils that curse the earth. My dear friends, we will never get very far in dealing with moral and social issues until we realize and recognize that behind the evils in our world today is the energizing and organizing mind of a personal devil. Our Lord pictures the devil as a thief that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Peter warned the believers in his second epistle, chapter 5 and verse 8. Here is what he says: "Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour." The name Satan means adversary or opposer. Satan is described in Scripture as the accuser of the brethren. He is a malignant spirit. In verse 8 of chapter 1, the Lord said to Satan, "Hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feareth God and departs from evil?" Satan answered the Lord and said, "Doth Job fear God for naught?" He accuses God of having put a hedge about Job. Then Satan raises the challenge, "But put forth thy hand now and touch all that he has, and he will curse thee to thy face." God accepts the challenge and permits Satan to afflict Job. Meanwhile, Job and his family are going about their lives without any suspicion of impending danger or catastrophe. Job has not the slightest idea about what Satan has in mind for him. Job was in for a shake-up. Everything has gone Job's way for a long time, but not anymore. When trouble strikes, it really strikes, my friend. In rapid succession, Job receives four messengers who bring him bad news, the worst coming at the last. God had told Satan, "All that he has is in your power. Only upon himself do not put forth your hand." Now, these messengers bring him word that all that he has, with the exception of his wife, is gone. A combination of natural disasters and human violence wrecks Job's possessions and his family. His oxen and asses are stolen and his servants killed. Lightning kills the sheep and their shepherds. His camels are stolen and those that took care of them killed. Then the worst news: his sons and daughters are killed by a hurricane. That was indeed a lot of bad news for one person to receive in such a short period of time. How will Job take it? Will he still serve God after all these calamities? The writer of this account tells us that Job was touched and hurt deeply. He rent his robe, a token of his torn heart. He shaved his head. He fell upon the ground, symbolizing his utter brokenness. but he also worshiped. Yes, Job was broken, my friend, but he would not turn away from God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In the spirit of true worship, he said, naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. What supreme dedication and devotion to God, my friend. Job is truly a model of submission to God and of trust in God. Job submitted himself to the wise providence of God and blesses the name of the Lord. How is it with you, my dear listener? Do you feel as though you can't make it anymore? Is the pressure piling up in your home, in your marriage, on the job? This morning on the broadcast, I sense that there are so many listening whose lives are filled with confusion. Yes, there are problems on every hand. The fierce winds of adversity are blowing. The storm is raging. You are beginning to wonder, does God really care? Is God concerned? Like the troubled disciples on the stormy sea, you are crying out, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Do not despair, child of God. Your God will not let you down. He has promised never to leave you nor to forsake you. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall raise up a standard against him. Listen to these words of comfort found in the book of Isaiah. I want you to turn to chapter 43 and let us read together from verse 1. Just pick up your Bible and turn to that portion quickly. It reads, But now thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and you can put your own name right there. God is talking to you. The word says, But now thus saith the Lord that created thee, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name, thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. My friend, Job couldn't read these words of comfort. Nonetheless, he had the confidence that God was with him. So in the face of disaster and great material loss, the Bible declares that Job worshipped. You can do the same this morning, my friend. The grace of God can enable you to sing with the hymn writer, My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. When darkness seems to hide his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. His oath, his covenant, his blood support me in the whelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. What about those of you, my friends, who have not yet committed your lives to Christ? It could be that many of you are experiencing serious problems. You're being harassed by Satan and his host, all because you have refused to surrender to Jesus. You have no peace in those circumstances. There is no fortitude and confidence. You see, it is only with Christ in the vessel that you can smile at the storm. Why not turn your life over to Jesus and cast all your cares upon him now as we pray? Father, we thank you for those bowing all along this radio altar. We thank you for your word which has gone forth and which has inspired new faith and confidence. We look to you today as the all-powerful God. We know that you are in control of every situation. So we bring our friends to you at this time. We ask you to touch them in a very special way. Strengthen the weak. Comfort the sad. Heal the sick. I pray for this family that is in distress at this time. Oh God, just minister your peace. And may your will be done in each life. Father, we thank you for those who are now surrendering their lives to you. We thank you for saving them. I release your anointing now to break every yoke in their lives. I set them free right now in Jesus' name. Friends, be sure to write us this week and let us know precisely what the broadcast is doing in your life and in your home. Then join us again next week, Lord willing, for another edition of Deliverance Time. Until God richly bless you, and remember, keep looking to Jesus. He will never, never let you down. God bless you.